within Aviva Europe, we had a business question, which was, what can we do that could unite and be relevant across all 11 of our markets, from Ireland to Turkey to Russia to France to Spain, etc., that would be relevant across all those markets, of genuine interest to all of our publics in terms of employees, customers, intermediaries, partnerships, advisors, government, and supported our brand positioning and our brand promise, which is around empathic experts and delivering prosperity and peace of mind to our customers. So we were looking for something that could tick a lot of those boxes and would also be something that we would sustain over time, not just a single campaign. And what we pulled out from the wave one for consumer attitude to savings this year was the retirement and pension issue. So there are themes across all the European countries around falling confidence and pessimism over the future, low levels of trust in financial institutions that we have to address directly, and a very, very growing unease about retirement. And you can see the social response, as John was talking about in terms of the social crisis, the social response in Greece from moving the state retirement age from 50 to 60, and the social response that's coming in France right now as they vote around moving the state retirement age from 60 to 62, and basically the public sector unions in particular are threatening to close France in protest at this outrageous betrayal of the promise of the state. So for us in the UK, we're facing 67 and rising. Of course, you think, you lucky buggers. This is a very topical, hot theme for us across Europe at the moment, where the social side of the capitalist system is a bit stronger maybe than in the UK. And then in terms of specifics, nearly one in five Europeans that have a pension plan have stopped paying into it over the last 2 years. They've stopped saving, even though they recognise they need to save previously. That's an issue for us, because we assume they'll carry on saving, and we make our profit projections and our persistency projections from that. It's an issue for the customers as well, because they're now facing a growing gap between what they're preparing for and what they can expect to achieve in retirement. One in three don't know, or even haven't thought about, what income they might need in retirement, and how that income should be spread from a very healthy golden age of 60s, when I'm backpacking across Peru, to a steadily declining health in the 70s, where I can be a bit more UK-focused, perhaps in a caravan, and then in my 80s, where I'm sort of sitting at home watching daytime TV, how your income is distributed over that retirement age. And then, of course, around 40% across all age bands are thinking about the need to work longer and delay their full retirement, or have a semi-retirement, where it's part-time work and part-time retirement. But they have no way of describing or calculating how long that should be, what type of thing they should do. So it's a very difficult question for consumers to answer. So we decided that the issue we wanted to address was, how do we quantify on a consistent basis across all of the EU and national EU nations a number, a figure, that we could then use to stimulate a debate. And we call that figure the pensions gap. And the pensions gap is basically, what is the annual gap for people retiring between 2011 and 2050, so the next 40 years, between their expectations of adequate income in retirement and the provision being made to meet this. And the OECD and other bodies describe an expectation of post-retirement income should be between 50 and 70% of your pre-retirement income. So with that expectation, what is the gap that people need to, what people are doing right now to provide for that? And from that question, we can get into issues of longer life expectancy, quality of life in retirement, the need to fund long-term health care rather than rely upon state provision for that. The questions that we're working with the EU on is, how do we make sure that retirement isn't just longer in terms of life longevity, but is a rich experience for citizens. So across the European Union 27, the annual gap is 1.9 trillion euros. So if you take the expectation of people to retire between 50 and 70% of their pre-retirement income, and the sources that will meet that income around state and private provision, there's a 1.9 trillion euro gap. And in the UK, it's about 370 billion euros. We're second behind Germany, which is over 400 billion euros. That's a really, really big number, and it's too big to grasp. So within the research, within the report, we've broken it down to smaller and smaller numbers. So for the UK average, it's 12,000 euros per annum. UK citizens need to save themselves more than they're currently doing. Now that's 1,000 euros a month. That's out of reach of nearly every UK consumer. So the strategies to meet that gap and close that gap have to move beyond just saving more money. So the by defining the gap and looking at its size and talking about it consistently, we can then embark upon working with government to build strategies to set to close that, that isn't just reliant upon state or private sector pension provision, but looks at other assets and other incentives.